Well, once a thriving tourist destination, businesses in Hurtigruten Dam are on the brink of closure. The culprit, an exotic water plant called the hyacinth. The floating plant makes boat rides and fishing simply impossible. It also prevents a clear view of the water. This invasive plant, ironically, can still be beneficial as it can be harvested for fertilizer.
A destination of choice, now invaded by a roguish exotic plant which covers the water. It threatens tourism and related business in Hartebeespoort. Hyacinth has its origin in the Amazon. It was spotted in this dam about 4 decades ago. Its movement is determined by the direction of the wind. It survives through waste flowing into the dam. Its recent infestation of the dam is a threat to local businesses.
It has really affected our business in the way that we do water activities there, which means we have to use our boat inside the dam. And since that plant started spreading, it actually distracting our movement in the dam.
Our income has gone down at least 70% over the last 2 years. There's no income coming in, which makes it difficult for us to be able to carry on with what we're doing.
It does affect our view, and it also limits us to certain water sports.
This poses a threat to tourism and job security.
It doesn't just attack a guest house or a hotel or a game lodge. It attacks everybody within the industry. And that way I say that, including the retail outlets, including the petrol stations. Because when people come to Hartebeespoort Dam, that's exactly what they do. They come to a dam. This is the draw card of the suburb that we stay in.
Residents are concerned about the possibility of their property depreciating in value. For others, the hyacinth has created business opportunities. Papilele Matlaila spent millions to buy a hyacinth harvesting machine in Thailand.
The mechanical way was to get a harvester, which we call it a hyacinth harvester, which can sort of float onto the water and take the hyacinth and algae out of the water without any damage to the environment, any damage to the fauna and flora of the dam.
As the saying goes, one man's trash is another man's treasure. This plant here is also being used by some as a fertilizer. Haya Matla was granted permission to harvest and process the hyacinth and turn it into a fertilizer for plants and crops. It has created 26 jobs for locals.
We harvest mechanically. From there, we take it into our windrows, where we turn it using our compost turners, because we use a process called mineralization. And as you can see, this is our final product. It's a fully organic product where we can use it for any commercial farmers or co-ops or smallholders farmers.
The plant is also useful in that it feeds on the waste, cleaning the water in the process. Different methods have been implemented over the years to remove the hyacinth. Chemical spraying proved ecologically dangerous. Physical removal of the plant was done between 2006 and 2016, employing more than 100 locals.
The department, over 10 years, since 2006 to 16, have contained and maintained the hyacinths, removed it, we compost it, we add vermiculture composting even, and we use that compost to re-establish shoreline and floating wetlands on the dam. That is a principle that we want to see applied.
The department says hyacinth is also useful as it helps reduce algae whose stench may pose a health risk. Itumeleng Khajani, SABC News, Hartebeespoort.